Hello friends, welcome to the video tutorial of WordPress WooCommerce Multi-Vendor Marketplace. And in this video, I'm going to describe you that how can a seller add a simple product from his seller panel. For this, we need to move through the seller panel. After login, a seller can see a seller panel where all the options are available. There is an option add product. By pressing this, the seller can add a product to his store. For this, he need to provide some information to add a product. First of all, he need to provide the product name. Then a short description about the product. And then you need to choose the product category. Like we choose the category as clothing and t-shirt. Then you need to choose the product thumbnail which you want to display on the shop page. For this, you just need to press upload thumb and upload a file which you want to assigned to the product, for example this, and then select. So the thumbnail image will be added to the product. Then you need to enter the product SKU, which is simple t-shirt, and provide a regular price. If the shop has the same SKU, then you need to provide a different SKU from that. Then you need to provide the regular price. For example, it is 45 and a sale price if you want to provide. So for example, we provide a 39 of as a sale price. Then a seller can also enter a product short description. So we can put a very small short description here. Then you need to press the save button. After that, you need to choose the product type as simple. Then you need to move through the inventory tab. And if a seller want to manage the stock of the product at product level, then you need to check this option and provide the stock quantity. For example, we put a quantity as 100 as of now. Then you need to choose the stock status, whether he want to display as in stock or out of stock. Then you need to choose the allow back orders, whether he want to allow back orders, allow but notify customer, or he want to allow the back order. Then he need to choose the go through the shipping tab. Here he provide the weight and dimensions of the product, and he can choose the shipping class. For example, right now I put a weight of 150, 26, 22, and height is 45. Then he need to choose the link product. If the seller want to add this product into a group product, then he can choose the group product from here. And if you want to add only a simple product, then there is no requirement to choose this. After that, we move through the attributes. If a seller want to add some specific attribute to this product, then here he can add some attributes. Like we add some attribute here, which is color. And if you want to show these attributes on the product page, then choose option visible on the product page. Visible on the product page, then you need to choose the product status. Right now the status of the product is as draft, so if you want to make the product online, then he can choose the option online and press OK button. Then the seller can add image gallery also to the product. Here he need to choose the image which you want to add as a image gallery for that product. For this he need to press the option add product image and upload files. These files are added and he can add these files to the product. Now the product is completed and the seller provide all the information to the product, so he just need to press update option and the product will be added successfully. We can view this product under product list. So this is the product which we have added here, and now we can move through the front end to see that how this product will be available on the front end. So now on front end the product is available. It is the simple t-shirt. A buyer can directly add to cart this product by pressing add to cart button, or he can view all the information related to product on the product page. This is the option where we can see that the product is of the seller John Doe, and quantity of the product, the short description, and how many quantity a buyer want to purchase this product, and this is the image gallery which we added, SKU of the product and the categories where the product will be fall, and the about the product and additional information which we have added to the product. That's all for this video tutorial. If you have any query or suggestion regarding the plugin or regarding the process, you can mail us at support@webcool.com or you can raise a ticket at webcool.ubtest.com. Thanks for watching this video. Stay tuned for more updates. Thank you.